question that I have faced in the last 14 years of my career is, how did I become a radio jock? When I was a child, I wanted to become a bus conductor. Because whenever I used to travel by bus, I always thought the conductor had the power to manage the entire bus just with a bell. Now I used to get amused that by just ringing one bell, he controls the entire bus. I grew up a little bit and I wanted to be the Sarkar. Because every day in the newspapers, I used to read, Sarkar ne aaj ye decide kiya, Sarkar ne aaj wo decide kiya. And I used to ask my father, ye Sarkar dikhta kaisa hai? Who is he? I have never seen him. There are no pictures of this Sarkar. And my father used to smile at me and would say that you would grow up and you would know about him. And I used to think in my imagination that the Sarkar would be sitting up there along with God and managing the entire world. A few years later, I wanted to be a farmer, a teacher, a policeman, a doctor, an engineer. I was very fortunate that in my school, when I was in my 8th grade, 9th, 10th, we were taught the elements of engineering, elements of electrical and mechanical workshop technology. I used to do foundry, carpentry work, metal casting. We used to do the electric wiring. And when I was in my 12th grade, I realized I hated mathematics. So I didn't opt for engineering. I gave the entrance exam of architecture. I cleared the entrance exam. And during the entrance exam, I realized that there was a lot of mathematics involved with architecture also. So I said, chuck it. I went for biotechnology. I studied biotechnology. I was doing my post-graduation. My father passed away. I was the only child. My father, I come from a very humble background. My father was an extraordinary man, simple living, high thinking. So my mother had never worked outside and I was a fresh graduate. So I decided that I'll have to take care of the family and earn. LIC, my father used to work with LIC, Life Insurance Corporation of India, has a provision of giving a job on compassionate grounds to one of the family members of the deceased employee. So mom had never worked. I took up the responsibility. I took up the job. In fact, before my father passed away, we had planned our lives. I wanted to go to the US. I wanted to do my post-graduation there as well and do my PhD in genetics. I wanted to be a scientist. And I had thought that I would invent something in genetics that would help the humanity in the years to come. That was my plan. So I started working with LIC. I was a clerk. Most of you would have seen Rab Ne Bana Di Jodi. Shah Rukh Khan wearing formal clothes, sports shoes, Baalon Mein Tel, Bajaj Super with his tiffin box. So I worked with LIC as a clerk for 3 years. And radio happened by fluke. I went to a multiplex to watch a movie called Devdas. And when I got out of the movie, out of the cinema hall, there was a huge banner, a hoarding, Get Hunted, the first radio jockey hunt of India. I'm talking about the times of no reality shows, no TV shows where there were music competitions on TV. No, nothing of that sort. That was the first of its kind reality show. And I had no idea about it. I just got curious. I went there and asked them what was it all about. They told me there were auditions. We had to read out a script in 3 languages, English, Hindi and Gujarati. I went through the scripts and I asked them that could I make my own script because I found it a little frivolous. So they said, yeah, it's okay. You can come tomorrow. To cut a long story short, we had a series of auditions for over a period of 2 months. 1800 people had participated. And I happened to win the contest. They offered me a job. Radio Mirchi said, you will have to quit from your current job. And I told them that LIC is a pensionable job, a respectable job. Radio Mirchi had just started. I had no idea about what radio jockeying was all about. I told them that, you know, one fine day you would shut down your business and I would be a jobless person. So I was in a huge dilemma about what to do. I told them, may I work part-time? They said, no, we want a full-time radio job. So now this story changed my life. I went to my music class. I was about 45 minutes earlier than my scheduled time. So I had like 40 minutes, and fortunately there were no smartphones at that time. So there was no Insta, no Facebook to, you know, look into. So in the building where my music class was situated, there was a library. For the first time I entered the library, I had a lot of time. I thought, let me just go through a few books. And when I entered the library, there was a rack. There was a board. And the board said, this story will change your life. There was a pack of cards. And the instruction was written that, pick up one card, look at the number. There is a book. Open the page number that the card has suggested. Read the story. It will change your life. I said, okay. So I picked up a card, opened the book. This is the story. Once upon a time, God used to live with human beings on the earth. God used to be with human beings. He was visible. And a lot of human beings used to complain that, God, you are a bad manager. You've created this world, but you don't know how to manage it. There were a lot of contradictions. God was really fed up. Because one fine night, everybody would be praying that there should be rains tomorrow because we have planted a lot of trees, we want to do the farming, and there would be somebody who would be praying that, I want to wash my clothes, let there be sun. So the God was fed up with these contradictions and he wanted to disappear. One fine day, a farmer went up to the God and told him that, God, you are a bad manager. You have made this world, but you don't know how to manage it. The God said, now, okay, tell me, what's your advice? The farmer said, things should happen according to my will. The God said, granted. This moment onwards, you are the God. You have all my powers. You can do whatever you wish to. For 1 year, you have all my powers. Let's meet after a year. The farmer said, okay. Wow, batao. So, the farmer, obviously, according to his will, chose the best of the seeds, made the land fertile. Whenever he wished, there was sun. Whenever he wished, there were rains. He made everything optimum. Optimum pH of the soil, optimum wind, optimum rain conditions. Everything was just perfect. And there was good crop. So the crop really went high. And one fine day, the farmer went up to the Lord and told him that, see, look at the difference. Kaha tumhara kaam aur kaha mera kaam. Ye dekho. The God was impressed. He said, good job. Now, let's just check the quality of the crop. The crop were cut. Apna Gujarati ma kahi dundu. And they opened. You know, they were checking the crop. The wheat crop. And there was no wheat inside the crop. So the farmer asked, did you do any trick? What is this magic? The God said, you have all the power. You're still the God. I don't have the power. It is you who has made this crop. And the farmer said, what went wrong? There was everything which was perfect. The God said, that's what? The seed that you had sown did not have to struggle. Did not have to struggle to grow. And for growth, struggle is a given, is a must. There has to be a little bit of struggle. The seed has become important. It could grow for the first generation. It will not have the second progeny. And the take home of the story was that a wise man must realize that surrendering to a situation will help him grow. One should know how to fall with the fall and how to flow with the flow. Surrender takes you to greater benediction, and greater benediction would lead you to grace. This was the moral of the story. But for me, the take home was, I did not have to struggle. I had not realized my true potential. Until then, whatever I did in life was given me on a platter. Even the job that I had got with LIC was not because of me. was because of a certain situation. When my father passed away, I got the job. It was not because of my own potential. I did not have to do anything to earn that job. I had not done anything in life until then to earn my own potential. And I went up to my mom that evening and I told her about the story and I asked her advice. She said that you must resign from your current job and go ahead with this new proposition that life has given you, because it's an indication that life wants you to take up a challenge and jump into the sea. You may drown or you may sail through. It will be your own failure, your own success. Go ahead, I am with you. These were the words of my mother. And there we are talking about life. I am very happy to share this part of my life with you. And in these last 14 years, I have met a lot of people who have had a lot of real life stories of theirs to share with my listeners. And I've been very fortunate that I have met people who have made our lives beautiful. I'll give you one more example. Now, this was a story from a book. I'll give you a real life parable. 2 years ago, I did a concept on radio called Dil Garden Garden Ho Gaya. Everybody, each of us has a story to tell. So I said, enough of negativity in the front page of the newspaper, enough of negativity on the debates of the news channels. While you listen to me in the morning on radio, I want you to smile. I want you to feel positive about life. Let's share such positive stories. And there was a guy called Hitesh who emailed me about how he makes his life beautiful. He's a businessman. Every day while he goes to his work, he stops by to ask somebody, do you need a ride? Kya aapko lift chahiye? Uska ek hi shauk hai, kisko lift dena. Uska ek target hai life mein, ki zindagi mein 1 lakh logon ko lift dena hai. And the day he had emailed me, he said, main ab tak 1000 logon ko lift de chuka hun. And I gave him a call and I asked him about it. Why did you do so? He said that when I was a child, we came from a poor family and we didn't have a vehicle. We used to go to the school and used to come back. When we used to come back from the school, TV pe hamara favorite karyakram aane wala hota tha. To dekhne ke liye humko matlab koi vehicle to milta nahi tha. Aur us time pe wo bag bahut bhari lagta tha. Aisa lagta tha ki matlab koi lift de de yaar. Aur lift nahi milta tha. तो वो जो पुराना एक्सपीरियंस हमें जो हुआ है उसके लिहाज से मैं वो लोगों को लिफ्ट देता हूं जिनके पास व्हीकल नहीं है. ही मेक्स अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल्स लाइफ ब्यूटीफुल. एंड आई आस्क्ड हिम दैट कभी बुरा अनुभव हुआ? मैंने कहा तुम तो अच्छे आदमी हो लेकिन कभी कोई बुरा अनुभव हुआ? ही सेड ध्वनित एवरी डे ईच मॉर्निंग व्हेन आई ओपन माई कार एंड मैं कार में जब बैठता हूं आई प्रे टू द लॉर्ड कि भगवान आज तू आके मेरी गाड़ी में बैठना. तो कभी बुरा अनुभव नहीं हुआ. एंड ही सेड दैट अगर होता भी है तो क्या ज्यादा से ज्यादा क्या होगा, वो मेरी गाड़ी ले जाएगा ना, मैं चाबी दे दूंगा, मुझे 5 रुपया 10 रुपया दे दे मैं रिक्शा में चला जाता हूं यार. आई सेड दैट दिस इज द स्पिरिट दैट यू हैव. आई टोल्ड हिम दैट यू शुड हैव 100 कार्स, यू शुड ओन 100 कार्स एंड आपकी सारी की सारी गाड़ियां ऐसे अच्छे काम में इस्तेमाल होनी चाहिए. देर आर लॉट ऑफ पीपल अराउंड अस हु डू ग्रेट वर्क एंड आर नेवर you know, in the limelight, but these are the people who are real heroes who spread a lot of positivity. So I request all of you to take a pledge that in the pursuit of your lives, in the pursuit of the happiness of your lives, you will ensure that you would make other people happy as well. You will be the reason for other people's happiness and not somebody else's failure. Thank you very much.